Welcome to Wilkes Now. I'm Angelina Davis.
And I'm Gracie Franco.
Let's take a look at what we have on today's show.
Hi, y'all. I'm Ariel Reed. Tune in later for your predictions of Thanksgiving break.
Hello, everyone. I'm Cabrini Renicki, the editor-in-chief for The Beacon. And on today's Beacon Briefs, I'll tell you what's in the news this week. Don't forget that you can grab your own copy of The Beacon at any campus building. I'll have more coming up soon. See you in a few.
I'm Kirsten Peters.
And I'm Eric Biteman.
Today, we have a brief Colonel rundown on Sports Now.
Then, Ben Mandel will follow our segment by sitting down with men's ice hockey head coach Tyler Hines.
We'll see you back here soon for more.
So Gracie, it's officially the start of the holiday season and this week is Thanksgiving. Do you have any traditions or plans that you have going on this break?
Yep, every Thanksgiving I go to my aunt's house and have Thanksgiving dinner with her and her family. So we do that every year. What about you?
So usually we have Thanksgiving with a little bit of a Christmas flair with it because my family comes down on my mom's side. So we do Thanksgiving and then we do like decorating for Christmas and Black Friday and all that fun stuff. So we're really excited for the holiday season.
Oh, that's awesome.
Don't forget, if you are looking for a spring internship, Handshake has 424 internships available right now. Go to joinhandshake.com to search for internships or jobs and join now if you haven't already. Use your time over break to apply and interview. Questions? Contact Sharon Castano at wilkes.edu at the Center for Career Development and Internships.
The Wilkes University Honors Program is partnering up with the Student Development Office and the Campus Interface Office to serve the Wilkes-Barre community. They are seeking donations now through Friday, December 6th. Items in need are winter hats, scarves, socks, gloves, or mittens. You could bring your donations to the Stark Learning Center rooms 120 and 122. Please bring donation items during the week between 8:30 a.m. and 4 p.m. The Honor Program thanks you for your generosity and your willingness to help those in need this holiday season. If you have any questions, please email honors@wilkes.edu. Now let's take it over to Cabrini for this week's Beacon Briefs.
Welcome to the Beacon Briefs. I'm Cabrini Renicki, the editor-in-chief for the Beacon here at Wilkes. Here's what's been happening. Resident Hall Council is hosting their annual door decorating contest, Deck the Halls. To participate, decorate your door, take a picture, and email it to rhc@wilkes.edu or DM it to wilkes_rhc on Instagram. Voting for the most festive door will take place during RHC's study break. Final submissions are due by Tuesday, December 3rd. The winning door will receive a $100 Amazon gift card per roommate. Dr. Benjamin Toole, Assistant Professor of Political Science, will be holding a lecture titled, What is Impeachment Anyway? The presentation will take place on December 3rd at 11 a.m. in Bryceth 106. The lecture will focus on the political origins and history of impeachment in the United States and its impact on today. Interested in helping those in need during this holiday season? Wilkes University Honor Program is pairing with the Student Development Office and the Campus Interfaith Office to collect donations through December 6th. Items to be collected include winter hats, scarves, socks, and gloves. Donations can be brought to SLC 120 through 122 during the week from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Questions can be directed to honors@wilkes.edu. Thanks for checking in, guys. That's all I have for today. I'm Cabrini Renicki, and this is Beacon Briefs. Now let's get back to the studio.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to another episode of the 4-Minute Gourmet. I'm your host, Mark Stein, along with my co-host,
Madison Homer.
All right, welcome, and thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for letting me join you.
I gather you're not much of a cook?
Not much at all.
Okay, well, you're going to learn a lot today, I think.
Good, because I could use this.
Very good. We're going to do some fajitas today.
Perfect.
We're going to give them a little bit of a twist, though. Instead of doing some standard fajitas, we have a couple of ingredients. We're going to kind of make a wet fajita with some barbecue sauce. So let's quickly go across the ingredients that we have ready to go here for today.
Cool.
We have barbecue sauce. You can use any kind of barbecue sauce you want, any popular brand. This one happens to have a little bit of a bourbon flavoring, maybe because I like bourbon, but that has a nice bourbon flavor that I think will give it some bourbon honey nuances that I think will be really nice. Mm-hmm. Up next here, I have some mesquite seasoning. You can use any dry seasoning, but the mesquite gives it a nice smoky flavor.
Gotcha.
Then we have our main ingredients here, which include some cut up green peppers, red peppers, and some onions. Kay. Pretty standard for fajitas. What I did was I went to the store, and you can buy these already cut up. So for somebody who doesn't cook or you know, want to chop things up, we can make it really, really simple. Exactly. So they're ready to go. Then I got some chicken. Now, I like to use the pre-cooked chicken. Then you don't have to mess with raw chicken and worry about cross-contaminating things and getting all kinds of germs in your food, et cetera, and washing all the time. So this is pre-cooked chicken. I got it at the deli section. You can buy it in packages. For this recipe where we're going to be adding lots of flavor to the chicken, I opted for the unflavored chicken. You can get them in different flavors, but I opted for the unflavored. And then, of course, some tortilla shells. So shall we get cooking?
Yeah, I think we should.
All right, sounds wonderful. All right, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get the tortilla shells into the pan. I like to put a few in the pan at one time, and then I just kind of flip them around and mix them around and so on. That way I can heat several at one time. The next thing that we want to get into the pan is going to be our vegetable ingredients. So the green peppers, red peppers, and onions going right into the pan, like so. And I always like to pre-season the pan with some kind of oil, canola oil or something like that. You really don't need a whole lot, particularly if you're using a non-stick pan, but that keeps things from sticking. So we want to move those things around a little bit, toss them like that, and let those get warmed up and cooked. The next thing we're going to be doing is putting in the chicken ingredient. So we'll also flip our tortilla shells here real quickly. There we go.
Awesome.
So what do you like to cook when you're at home? Anything at all?
If I had to pick, I'd probably say some pre-made pierogies.
Oh, pre-made pierogies.
Pre-made
pierogies.
All right.
I had a little
seasoning,
that's good.
So
that's
it's a little bit my own, but other than that, it's pre-made.
Well, you can call it your own if you made the seasoning.
It's fine.
So
it was made at home, so it's homemade.
Fantastic. Sounds good. All right. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to add the chicken to this. And we're going to basically let that chicken heat up because we really don't need to cook the chicken. It just needs to warm as we wait here. And we'll flip that around. Would you like to try a flip?
I don't know if I should.
I'll tell you what, I'll give you a hint. Here's what you could do, right? We'll switch and you can come over and you could just do one of those. How does
that
sound?
I'll give it a little
okay?
One of those. I don't think I can do that much damage. Over here like this.
There you go. Perfect.
Good?
Excellent. Yep.
Awesome.
I thought that was good.
And no
great.
Spills.
No spills at all. Excellent. All right. So we'll just let that warm for a moment yet. I'm still warming the tortilla shells. We'll flip them around like so.
Okay.
This is a really, really quick meal that you can do. Mm-hmm. And I usually try to focus on things that only take a few minutes. A lot of the stuff is prepped ingredients that you buy in the store. And a lot of this stuff is stuff you could do either at home really quickly in the evening or something that you could do in your apartment, et cetera. So
now
that's the idea.
Now, what temperature do you have the chicken?
I have the chicken and the veggies at medium-high.
Gotcha.
We don't want to burn them, right? But we do want to get that nice and warmed up. Okay. So long about this time, as the vegetables are heated and as the chicken is starting to heat through, the first thing I'm going to do is add some of this mesquite seasoning. So let's toss that in there.
Just a little dash.
Yeah. I like a lot of flavor in my food, and as a result, I probably use a little more than the average person would use. So once that's in there, we're gonna toss that around a little bit, like so.
Give you a lot of credit for doing that.
Takes a little practice, but honestly, it's not that difficult. Not that difficult to do. So let's flip our tortillas one more time. You can use any kind of tortilla that you would like to use for this particular recipe or application. It's completely up to you. I just went with the standard flour tortillas. Mm-hmm. The reason I went with the standard flour instead of corn or something like that is it allows the flavor of what I'm making here, the chicken and the fajita mix, to come out. In other words, the additional flavor of the tortilla shell is kind of minimized so you can really taste the ingredients. And at this point, we're going to add our barbecue sauce. As I said, this is a honey bourbon barbecue sauce, so let's put that right in there. And we're set on that. And let's give it one last flip around here. And just make sure all of that is mixed through.
Now, I'm assuming you can do a lot with this kind of recipe, adding different sauces.
You could do a whole variety of different things. You could literally go into the store and pick a different sauce every time you made it, different seasoning every time you made it, and you'd be all set. So why don't we plate this up? We'll give it a try, okay?
Gotcha.
So I'll grab that. We'll take a little bit of the chicken. Little bit of the peppers and the onions. And basically roll it. If you want to do the rolling, you're welcome to
do
that.
Part.
And then give it a try. See what you think. I hope the verdict is a good one.
It is a good one. The barbecue sauce is really good with that.
Great, great. That kind of amps it up a little bit, I think, and it makes it not a standard fajita. It makes it just a little bit more interesting.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever actually had, a fajita that had barbecue sauce on it. It was more like salsa, things like that.
Exactly, exactly. So we spice it up a little bit and make it something a little bit different than what you would normally get.
Awesome.
Wonderful. All right, so that's another edition of the 4-Minute Gourmet. I'm Mark.
I'm Madison Hummer.
And we'll see you next time. Take care.
Thanks, Maddie and Dr. Stein. Wilkes Now will be right back after this public service announcement.
A father and a husband. I'm a professional golfer. I am a colon cancer survivor. And I fight because I want people to survive what they're going through and live long, happy lives. It's the second leading cause of death of any cancer. Probably something most folks don't know. But it's also one of the most treatable forms of cancer. So you can prevent this by proactively doing things about it. And many times you're going to find out that it's be a lifesaver to do that.
My name is Blake. I received a heart transplant when I was 2 weeks old. I play defense for the Red Hot Tornadoes. Sometimes my heart starts pounding like faster and faster as I go. I know I have someone else's heart inside me. It makes me feel happy because someone was generous enough to give me a second chance to live.
This gift of life was made possible by an organ donor. Imagine what you could make possible. Sign up as an organ, eye, and tissue donor. Go to organdonor.gov.
Welcome back. Attention seniors, senior photos for the 2019-2020 yearbook will take place on Monday, December 2nd, Tuesday, December 3rd, and Wednesday, December 4th in the Henry Student Center First Floor Lounge. All photo sessions need to be scheduled in advance. Please go online to www.ouryear.com to schedule your appointment. The Wilkes school code is 222. You may also call 1-800-687-9327 to schedule an appointment during business hours. There is no cost to be photographed, but please remember to schedule your session. If you are a P2 student and want a yearbook, you will need to get your picture taken this year. There will not be an opportunity for you in your P4 year. For more information, contact Megan Pitts in the Student Development Office at 570-408-4111 or email her at megan.pitts@wilkes.edu. Now let's send it over to Tyler and Sean for this week's pizza review at Gary's.
All right, Thanks for a few time. This is the finale, Sean.
We are at
big time.
Jerry's. Last week we were at Angelo's trying the sweet sauce pizza. Angelo's versus Jerry. Special guest, Sean Austin, Pizza King.
Back
here in
Wilkes. Back at it, baby.
So last time he gave Angelo's a 10. So
10 out of 10.
That's his favorite. So I gave it a 7.4, which is Angelo's, which is the highest score that I've given. So Jerry's is going to be the test. We'll see which one's better. So let's take the tape off. As last week, we got the sweet sauce pizza.
Sweet sauce, once again.
Baby. All right. I'm liking the look of this.
That baby sauce up right.
I'm liking the look of this. I'm liking the design on it. Get a little shot of that. Alrighty, so you're not going to call this one Heaven in a Box, I guess.
No, I can't. I can't.
You're not going to call it Heaven in a Box.
Paradise, baby. We'll call this one Paradise.
Fair enough. Alright, well, I'll let you grab a slice. I'm having a hard time grasping this.
Yeah, let's...
There we go.
Get that off of there. Jeez Louise. We're back at it with
back
the thin
at
crust.
It. There's definitely... It looks like there's a lot more sauce on this pizza.
Yeah. Yeah.
compared to Angelo's, so we're gonna try the sweet sauce.
Take a bite here.
Ooh. All right, it's interesting. So while we're trying this pizza, you were in there getting the synopsis on the history between Angelo's, Jerry's, and Ricky's.
Yes.
So what have you found out for us?
Well, Angelo's opened up in 1960. You know, owner and creator Angelo Ricci, the late Angelo Ricci, he opened it. His sons, Angelo Ricci Jr. and Jerry Ricci, they opened up the following restaurants. Jerry Ricci opened up Jerry's, and Angelo Ricci Jr. opened up Ricci's. Here we are today at Jerry's, known for their Wisconsin cheese, California sauce. But here we have the sweet sauce, which is the biggest thing that separates, you know, the three restaurants from the rest. And having a revelation today here, you know, I think this is better than Angelo's.
No.
And I would never in my life ever. This is the first time I've ever said this.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
100%. Like, you're not just saying this.
This isn't for show, for TV, whatever. This was better.
Oh my goodness.
Well, so if Angelo was a 10.
That's what I said. That was part of the problem I said last week. I was like, well, if you're giving it a 10, nothing can be higher. So, I mean.
Right.
Well,
but
I mean.
This is. I don't remember it tasting like this. They did something right today. Because this is amazing. You can look back at the replay. My first bite. You saw the expression on my face, man. This is. I can't believe that. I'm starstruck. I can't talk right now.
My goodness.
This is amazing.
This is kind of crazy. So I'm gonna try the crust here, get the crunch. Perfect crunch on the crust. I love that. It's thin. Overall, the entire pizza is not as crunchy as Angelo's. It's a little softer. There's a little bit more sweet sauce, but I do like the sweet sauce. So, I mean, I'm really surprised you said this is better than Angelo's.
God.
I can't believe that. I thought, you know, you're true and through on Angelo's. So
today, I don't know. It might be a special day. You might see a rainbow later. This is.
So, I mean, I don't know how we're going to do your score here. I mean, it's on a scale of 1 to 10.
We're going to go another 10 2 weeks in a row.
So he's giving it a 10 2 weeks in a row. Man. I probably got sweet sauce all over my face,
yeah.
But. I'm really thinking this one through. This is a big review, like I said. I mean, Angelo's and Jerry's, people have been honest to try these two with Sean.
Yeah, this is big time.
And these are the two, you know, big pizza places in Wilkes-Barre, so. If I really gotta be honest, I mean, this is a very good pizza. I'm probably gonna surprise quite a few people here, but I think this is better than Angelo's. I'm gonna give this one an 8.2. This is a very good pizza. Better than Angelo's, I gotta say Jerry's. Top notch here in Wilkes-Barre. Better than Angelo's. As far as I'm concerned, it's the best one we've had. So, out of all the pizza places. So, that's a pizza review. Sean, that's it for the semester. We hit the top. We hit the peak. Jerry's 8.2 in Wilkes-Barre.
Wow.
That's the peak, you know?
Jerry's, man.
So, well,
y'all impressed me. That's all I'll say.
So, that's going to do it for pizza review. Back to the studio for more.
thanks Tyler and Sean. The Commuter Council will hold a winter gear giveaway at 11 a.m. on Tuesday, December 3rd in the Henry Student Center. They will have free Wilkes beanies and Wilkes ice scrapers for the first 250 students. You can also enter a drawing to win an oil change gift certificate. It's time to send it over to Kirsten and Eric for Sports Now.
Welcome to Sports Now. I'm Kirsten Peters.
And I'm Eric Biteman.
At the Pablo Cotto tip-off tournament, Wilkes men's basketball outscored Montclair State University 96-91 in the championship competition.
Senior guards Rob Pecorelli and Mark Mullins each surpassed the 1,000 career point milestone during the game to lead the Colonels to victory.
Pecorelli tied his career high of 33 points, while Mullins set a new career high of 27 points.
The Colonels currently sit at 5-1, with their next contest on the calendar being against Marywood on Wednesday, December 4th.
In addition to the success of Colonel basketball on the court, men's ice hockey has been successful in the rink, posting a 6-1 overall record to date.
With back-to-back contests this weekend, Wilkes defeated crosstown rival Kings 5-2 before defeating Albertus Magnus 6-1 at the Mohegan Sun Arena.
Sophomore forward Donald Flynn stole the show with a combined 5 goals between the two contests, including the eventual game winner against Kings as well as the hat trick against Albertus Magnus. Flynn's 5-goal weekend earned him both the MAC Offensive Player of the Week and the UCHC Player of the Week honors.
Fellow sophomore forward Danny Rydell added a goal in each contest as well.
Sophomore forward Phil Erickson and freshman goaltender Michael Patterson-Jones have also been standouts for the Colonels this season with UCHC Weekly honors.
The Colonels will have a short Thanksgiving break traveling to Becker College in Worcester, Massachusetts for the Steve Hoare Invitational. They will face off with Suffolk in the first round on Saturday, November 30th at 5:30 p.m.
On the mat, the Colonel wrestlers struggled, only attaining one victory at the Scottywood Duels against Kent State, 54-6.
In their win, Wilkes earned extra points in all 9 of their victories, including 5 falls.
Wilkes currently stands at 4-4 and will look to improve their record at the Messiah Petrophis Invitational on December 6th and 7th.
As for Colonel football, their 2019 season has officially come to an end.
In their first postseason game since 2010, Wilkes suffered an 88-24 loss to number 15 Susquehanna University in the Centennial/MAC Bowl game.
Despite the score on the board, freshman wide receiver Nate Whitaker made 2 appearances in the end zone, while senior wide receiver Derek Nelson capped off his career with a final touchdown as a Colonel.
Colonel football concluded their season with an 8-3 overall record, with their 8 wins being the most since the 2006 season, when Wilkes went undefeated in regular season play and finished 11-1 overall.
As for the Beacon's Athlete of the Week, the final newspaper of the semester is already circulating around campus with each honoree.
On the men's side, it's senior football player Jose Chabora, and on the women's side, it's freshman basketball player Macy Berryman.
Visit any building on campus to grab your copy of the Beacon, and be sure to look at the sports section as well as the sports center spread.
That's all we have today for our brief Colonel recap. Be sure to stick around for Ben Mandel's interview with men's ice hockey head coach Tyler Hines, following the team's early season success. I'm Kirsten Peters.
And I'm Eric Biteman. I'll let you take it over, Ben.
Thanks, Eric. Today I'm joined by men's ice hockey coach Tyler Hines. Thanks for being with us here today, Coach.
Happy to be here.
So, this past weekend, the Colonels won both their contests with a 5-2 victory over Kings and a 6-1 victory over Albertus Magnus. Besides the first contest of the season against SUNY Canton, Wilkes has won 6 consecutive games. Coach Hines, what has been the team's reason for the early success?
I think a lot of it stems from how we finished last year and wanting to improve upon that, the bitter taste that it left in our mouth. I think we came in hungry this year and a little humbled by what took place at the end of last season. And last year we had a young group, a lot of freshmen, vast majority of our team, freshmen last year. Now as they become sophomores, maturing a little bit, and I think gaining a good understanding that in this league, we play in the UCHC, a strong league, night in, night out, it's gonna be a battle. And you can't take any nights off, unfortunately. We've gotten the results we wanted on the scoreboard. I think, if you asked any of the guys on the team or the coaching staff, myself or our assistant Ryan Secor, I think they'd all agree that we're not satisfied. I think we can be better, play a little better. But that being said, I'd be lying if I said we weren't happy with the results and how things are going on the ice so far.
So What are some adjustments you guys have made on the penalty kill? There were some rough patches on the unit the first couple of games, but the unit has seemed to tighten things up as of late.
No, definitely, and I'm glad you mentioned that because just brought up Ryan Sequer, our assistant coach. He's doing a tremendous job with that, and I think we've figured out kind of the personnel that have been successful for us on that unit, but also I think a lot of it is the buy-in that the players have to him. I think he's done a great job teaching it. We practice it quite a bit, but the penalty kill is a lot of gritty, a lot of sacrifice, blocking shots, working hard and without a lot of reward, but I think the reward is helping the team win hockey games, and we have a lot of good teammates and team players that are willing to do that.
So things have really clicked for your team on the power play as well, scoring at least one goal on the man advantage each game. 13 of the team's 32 goals so far this season have come on the power play. What is making the power play so successful?
I think the unit obviously has a lot of skill and talent, and I think true freedom to be creative offensively. I think one of the reasons it's been so successful is because of the hockey sense and the comfortability that those five guys have with each other. And that's something they were a unit for most of last year, and were very good last year as well. So, I don't want to say it's a surprise. I think the amount of success that they've had is encouraging, and I don't want to say surprising, but definitely encouraging. Mm-hmm. But I think a lot of it comes down to, urgency. And after you shoot the puck, power play, you get a lot of shots, being willing to go and get that puck back, and they've done a great job of that, having energy on when we do have a man advantage. And but I think a lot of it boils down to the ability and skill and comfortability that those five guys have with each other.
All right, so Coach, Donald Flynn was one of the most productive freshmen in the country last year, really one of the most productive players overall. It seems like he's finally starting to get that kind of production back right now as the seasons move forward, including five goals this weekend. What does Flynn mean to this team, and how important is he to the team's success? How important is it that he continues to produce?
I think he's obviously an important part of what we're trying to do here, not just last year, but this year moving forward. I think one of the things I'd like to mention, while obviously the five goals is great, I think, only one penalty in the last four games is huge as well. I think that the more he can be on the ice, I think the better for everyone, for us at least. And he's obviously an important part of everything that we're doing here, but I don't want his success to overshadow the other 27 guys that bring it every day. And a lot of guys that, and I was one of these players in college that you might not see in the score box and things like that, but do a lot of things throughout the week to lead to our success on the weekends, whether it's guys on the mock penalty kill going against our power play doing what the team we're playing is doing instead of what we do. And that's a sacrifice for the team to make the power play better, and I think a lot of credit for the power play success and guys' success overall goes to little things like that happening throughout the week.
So, lastly, this weekend, the team will be traveling to the Steve Hoare Invitational. What's the expected level of competition, and what do you expect out of your team and the competition as well?
I think we've set the bar pretty high at this point. I think, the competition's strong. We get to play some teams that we've never played before as a program, so that's exciting. And I think the most exciting thing is a chance to win our first trophy in program history. Obviously, last year being our inaugural season, had a tremendous amount of success, but came up short with the winning a trophy, winning a championship. So pretty cool that over Thanksgiving break, get to spend some time together as a team on campus when most of the students are gone, and come together as a group, and then chance to win a trophy this weekend. Doesn't get much more exciting than that.
All right. Thanks so much for being here today with us, Coach. We wish you and the men's ice hockey team the best of luck for the rest of the season. I'm Ben Mandel, and we'll be back after this public service announcement.
What if being in recovery from a mental or substance use disorder was something we proudly showed the world? You might be surprised. Millions of people are in recovery, sharing hope, help, and support with family, friends, and community. Join the Voices for Recovery. For 24-hour free and confidential information and treatment referral for mental and substance use disorders for you or someone you know, call 1-800-662-HELP.
You recycle, right?
Yep, it's confusing. It's hard for all of us to recycle properly when it's this confusing. Yet recycling is the number one thing we can do for the environment and the economy if we do it properly. We have a solution, and it's working.
The standardized labels help people recycle more, and they help people recycle right. Let's recycle across America, and let's recycle right.
To be part of the standardized label solution, visit letsrecycleright.org.
Hi, y'all. I'm Ariel Reed. Right now, we're looking at temperatures of 58 degrees currently, with a high of 60, and a low of 41 today. As you can see, Wednesday, we're looking at mostly cloudy skies with a high of 56 and a low of 38. We are anticipating a 30% chance of storms that day. On Thanksgiving, we're looking at partly sunny skies with a high of 41 and a low of 29. Friday, we're looking at mostly sunny skies again with a high of 41 and a low of 27. Saturday, we're looking at partly sunny skies with a high of 40 and a low of 33. We're also looking at a 70% chance of precipitation that day, and the precipitation should be a mix between snow and rain. And that snow and rain will carry over into Sunday, except for with a 60% chance of precipitation. Mostly cloudy skies, high of 42, low of 33. Monday, again, mostly cloudy skies with a high of 37 and a low of 33. Let's take a deeper look into the weather we're anticipating. So as you can see, on Tuesday, there's a storm developing in the Midwest region of America right now, and it'll slowly head towards the Northeast region where we are. But as you can see on this side, there is another storm, so that's where our snow will be coming from over the weekend. So let's take a more in-depth look. As you can see, on Wednesday in the morning, Wilkes-Barre area is in the light green region, so we're not anticipating rain right away. But as you can see throughout the day progresses, that Wilkes-Barre eventually ends up in the dark green region, which means there's a higher chance of rain that day. But it shouldn't last for long, because later in the day, we're back in the light green region. So looking ahead, temperatures are to rise until Wednesday and then steadily decline throughout the week. We are anticipating rain Tuesday evening throughout Wednesday, and we are anticipating yet again snow on the weekend. I'm Ariel Reed, back to y'all at the news desk.
That's all the time we have for today. Just a reminder, you can watch us live every Tuesday on Service Electric Channel 97 at noon. Also, check out our YouTube channel for episodes of the show and more.
And in case you missed it, our broadcast re-airs every weeknight at 7:30 p.m. I thank you very much for watching. From all of us here at Wilkes Now, have a great week.